Hi, I'm Adam Kimelman, Deputy Managing Editor of NHL.com. This year marks the 60th anniversary of the first NHL Draft in 1963. To commemorate the Diamond Anniversary, NHL.com has selected the top 60 draft picks of all time. Welcome to 60 Diamonds, the greatest picks of the 60 NHL Drafts. In this episode of 60 Diamonds, we will cover numbers 60 through 51 and do a deeper dive into the criteria used to select the 60 greatest picks. Joining me today to discuss are Mike Morial and David Satriano from NHL.com. Guys, thanks for joining me.
Adam, it's a pleasure to be here with you and Dave.
You guys are the draft experts. I'm just glad to be a part of this project.
Before we get going, how does a list like this come together? Well, the first step is to define what a top draft pick is, and that can go in a lot of different directions. Is it picking who you think could be a surefire Hall of Famer at number one, like a Guy Lafleur, Mario Lemieux, Sidney Crosby, or Connor McDavid? Or is it a mid-round pick that emerges as a franchise cornerstone? What about that player a team takes a late-round flyer on that develops into a top-of-the-lineup stalwart? As you can tell, it's a pretty simple question, but pretty difficult to answer. So NHL.com enlisted a panel of 13 writers and editors to determine who were the top 60 draft picks of all time. Let's get to it. Now, guys, what stood out to me, 13 ballots, 60 slots, 172 players got at least one vote, which I think really speaks to the difficulty of putting this list together. So, Mike, I'll start with you. When you're laying this out, what are you emphasizing to make your top 60 draft picks?
Yeah, it's not easy, but I valued draft picks that weren't necessarily first-round selections, but became bona fide NHL stars and remain with the NHL club that drafted them for 4 or 5 years. Now, they could have won a couple NHL awards, maybe a Stanley Cup championship, maybe two, but it all comes down to the fact that that player was with that particular team, and that team was able to benefit from their performance.
Dave, the hard thing was, for a lot of people, was defining what is a top draft pick. So in your mind, what was a top draft pick for you?
So I kind of agree with Mike, but for me, the guy needed to have been drafted by the team. Couldn't have been drafted by someone else and traded. I felt like I needed to reward the players who got the teams who drafted them. And the second big thing for me was I didn't put anyone on my list who has made his NHL debut in the last 5 years, just because for me it was a little too small of a sample size. I mean, there's definitely some guys in the next 10 years who could be there, but for me, 5 years and under was too new for me to get on this list.
So let's start at number 60. And it was a very tight squeeze to get number 60, Kirill Kaprizov from the Minnesota Wild, in there. It's a one vote difference between number 60 and number 61. So, Mike, you had Kaprizov at number 23, highest among all of us. What was it about Kaprizov that, in your mind, made him a top draft pick?
Well, when you talk about, you know, diamonds in the rough and draft picks that really paid off, Kaprizov, to me, for the Minnesota Wild, in the fifth round, is a feather in their cap and what they were able to accomplish. He was number 29 in NHL Central Scouting's final ranking of international skaters. You're not sure where he's going to fall. But since Kaprizov entered the league in 2021, he ranks fourth among all players drafted in 2015 in points per game. And that's behind McDavid, Rantanen, Mitch Marner. So he's right up there with those elite, elite players. So for me, it was a fantastic choice by the Minnesota Wild.
So we talked about the variety of the lists. Now, among this group of 10 guys that we're talking about today from 51 to 60, only one was on all three of our ballots, which I found really interesting. Mike Richter at number 55. Dave, you had him at number 42. What was it about Richter, in your mind, that makes him such a great draft pick?
Well, first of all, he was drafted in the second round, which, as we know with goalies, if you're drafting them that early, hopefully you found a good one. The Rangers found a good one, 12, 14 years with them. Won 20 games, I think 10 times. Obviously the cup with them. He had 300 something wins. He was their original sixth franchise. He was first in wins until Henrik Lundqvist a few years ago. He meant so much to that team. He was probably, I could have even ranked him a little higher, but I thought this was a pretty good spot for him. And, you know, the Rangers just seem to churn out these goalies. They draft these goalies and they do a pretty good job.
That they do. I'm with you. I had Richter high up on my list. I think he was outstanding. Let's look a little more contemporary. Nikita Kucherov from the Tampa Bay Lightning at number 52 on the list. Mike, you had him at number 28, second highest among all 13 of us. What was it in your mind about Kucherov that makes him such a great draft pick?
Again, Kucherov, great value for where Tampa Bay was able to get him. He was number 17 on Central Scouting's final ranking of international skaters that year. So you're not sure where he's going to fall, but Al Murray, who was director of amateur scouting for the Lightning that year, you know, he knew that Kucherov was going to be a diamond in the rough, and sure enough, he was. Look, you know, they won two Stanley Cups with Kucherov there in 20 and 21. Both seasons, he led the playoffs in scoring. So to me, Kucherov, great player. He helped Tampa Bay get to where they wanted to be. Fantastic pick in the second round at number 58.
So a guy I want to talk about, number 51 on the list, Grant Fuhr. I had him at number 17. You guys didn't have him ranked at all. To me, picking a goalie in the first round, always a difficult thing. Goalies are so difficult to judge. So if you're going to take one in the first round, you got to be really confident in him. And I think Fuhr certainly rewarded that confidence. Five-time Stanley Cup champion. And I think what made them so good is you take Fuhr's numbers out of the mix. They're, you know, if you looked at them in today, he would probably not even be a backup, right? But he was the backbone for those teams that allowed Gretzky, Anderson, Messier, Curry to go and be as daring and brave and creative as they wanted. Because if they gave the puck away, if they got caught up ice, well, there's a Hall of Famer in goal in Grant Fuhr to be the backbone behind them. And that's why his name and a lot of those guys' names are on the Stanley Cup so many times. Dave, you didn't have Fuhr on there. Was there just guys above him that you thought were better value?
I had Fuhr at 61 on my list. I know we didn't go that far, but that's where I had him. There's no arguing. He's got a cup ring on every one of his fingers, 400 wins. You mentioned the numbers. To me, it was just, I just felt that because their offense was so good, he didn't, you know, maybe he just knew he didn't have to make every save, but he did. The numbers to me just, you know, his save percentage was under 900. The goals against was 3.5, which you mentioned in today's game, he wouldn't be a backup. But I guess back then with all the offense, you know, that wasn't so bad. He is one of the 100 greatest players. He's a Hall of Famer. So 61, I just had him out on my list.
Well, that's great debate. Mike, Dave, thank you for joining me on this episode of 60 Diamonds. We looked at our voting criteria as well as numbers through 60 through 51. Join us next Sunday as we are back and chat about numbers 50 to 41. This countdown will culminate with the release of numbers 20 to 1 on June 24th at 7 p.m., airing on NHL Network. For Mike Morial and Dave Satriano, I'm Adam Kimelman. Thank you for watching this episode of 60 Diamonds, the greatest picks of the 60 NHL Drafts.